particle physics would be nothing without detectors. But this is what they used to look like. A cloud chamber, filled with supersaturated alcohol vapor. When energetic charged particles travel through it, they rip off the electrons of the air molecules, leaving behind an ionized trail of gas. These ions then attract the alcohol, acting as condensation centers, which allow a cloud to form. Particle physicists used to take photographs of these cloud tracks and use those to work out what was happening. Bubble chambers worked in much the same way, but instead of supersaturated vapor, it was superheated transparent liquid. And instead of clouds forming, it was visible bubbles. But things now are quite a bit different. The experiments as part of the LHC are incredibly complicated. So how do particle detectors work in the 21st century? ATLAS is one of the two general purpose experiments at the LHC. Its inner detector tracks particles, just like a cloud chamber. But by using pixel detectors and semiconductor trackers, it's silicon chips that are doing this electronically. It also has a combined transition radiation detector and straw tracker, which detect particles by using materials with lots of different refractive indices and a combination of gas and wires, respectively. The outer detectors measure the energy deposited by the particles in these calorimeters. And the experiment produces a tremendous amount of heat, which has to be cooled by all this water. The ALICE experiment, which looks at heavy ion collisions at the LHC, also uses pixel detectors similar to ATLAS, and this is what they look like. But this is its main tracker, which works a bit like a wire chamber, filled with gas that gets ionized and wires to send the signals. LHCb, an experiment focusing on bottom quarks, also has one of these. Here it is. It also has two optical detectors, picking up the light produced by the particles through scintillation and Cherenkov radiation. Thanks so much for watching this video. Let me know, which detector did you find the most interesting? Write in the comments below and do like and subscribe for more stuff from me. Cheers.